Long ago, somewhere deep in the jungle, there lived a very spoiled llama.
Will you take a look at that? Pretty pathetic, huh? Well, you'll never believe this, but that llama you're looking at was once a human being. And not just any human being. That guy was an emperor. A rich, powerful ball of charisma. Oh, yeah! This is his story. Well, actually my story. That's right. I'm that llama. The name is Cuzco. Emperor Cuzco. I was the world's nicest guy, and they ruined my life for no reason. Oh, is that hard to believe? Look, I tell you what, you go back a ways, you know, before I was a llama, and this will all make sense.
Right. Okay. Long ago, a mighty kingdom celebrated the birth of the heir to its throne. The tiny babe was destined one day to become emperor.
All right, now see, that's a little too far back. Oh, look at me! That's me as a baby! All right, let's move ahead.
Oh, come on, Mr. Llama Face. I'm the narrator, and you're the llama, the emperor, whatever, okay? But I tell the story, and you act it out. Got it, Mr. Whatever Emperor? Okay, let's see. Long ago, there was an emperor named Cuzco who was, young, handsome, and very powerful.
Oh, yeah.
Cuzco was on top of the world. He was waited on hand and foot. Everybody did as Cuzco commanded. He was also spoiled, self-centered, and nasty. The guy was a real jerk. I'm talking major brat, completely. Yeah, well, sorry. Okay, back to the story. One day, as Cuzco neared his 18th birthday, one of Cuzco's royal assistants sought out all the eligible young maidens in the empire and brought them to the palace.
Your Highness, it is time for you to choose your bride.
Ha! Boom, baby!
Alrighty. Trot out the ladies. Let's take a look-see.
The young women were beautiful. They were elegant. They were kind. But, of course, our little spoiled emperor had a hard time acknowledging this. As he walked down the line of ladies, examining them, he couldn't manage to squeeze out even an ounce of politeness as he commented about each one.
Hate your hair. Not likely. Yikes, yikes, yikes. And let me guess, you have a great personality.
Finally, Cuzco turned toward the royal official who had spent days, no, weeks, trying to find a match for the young emperor.
Is this really the best you could do?
Yes. No. Perhaps. I really don't know.
The royal official didn't know what to say. After all, how is one to respond to an emperor who thinks of nothing but himself? If Cuzco was spoiled, Yzma was just plain wicked. At least there was some hope that Cuzco could learn a lesson and grow a heart. But Yzma, yuck. She wasn't just heartless. She was actually purple from the lack of blood being pumped from her lack of heart. She also had this little lab set up in the dungeon where she concocted potions and poisons. We'll get a little more into that later. But for now, if you're thinking she sounds like a witch, you're pretty much right on target. So, back to Cuzco. He saw Yzma perched atop the incredibly high pedestal that served as Cuzco's throne. Yzma was peering down at a poor peasant.
It is no concern of mine whether your family has... What was it again?
Food.
Ha! You really should have thought of that before you became peasants. We're through here. Take him away. Next!
But I...
So that gives you a pretty good picture of Yzma. Except that she always had a new assistant to keep her entertained. This year's model was Kronk. Kronk was big and buff and good-looking, and, well, not so bright. Kronk was standing next to Yzma when Cuzco arrived. Yzma was so surprised and scared to see the emperor see her sitting on his throne that she didn't quite know what to say.
Your Highness!
You were doing it again.
Doing what?
Doing my job.
So Yzma began chit-chatting rapidly, trying to get out of the fix she'd gotten herself into. But Kuzco wasn't really listening. He just kept thinking about how much he really disliked Yzma. In fact, he couldn't figure out why she was his advisor in the first place. Finally, after a long time of Yzma's panicky chit-chatting and Kuzco's spacing out, a servant interrupted with a message for Kuzco.
Excuse me, Your Highness. The village leader is here to see you.
Oh, great. Send him in.
Then Kuzco turned back to Yzma.
Oh, and by the way, you're fired.
Fired? What do you mean, fired?
How else can I say it? You're being let go, your department is being downsized, you're part of an outplacement. We're going in a different direction, we're not picking up your option. Take your pick. I got more.
Yzma was shocked. She was dismayed. She was wickedly furious. She stormed out of the throne room, dragging Kronk along with her. As Yzma departed, the village leader, Pacha, was escorted in to meet with Emperor Kuzco. Pacha was a kind, gentle man who lived in a mountaintop village in the middle of the jungle. He loved his family and he loved his home. But at the moment, he was a bit nervous about why the Emperor had called for him.
Afternoon, Your Highness. I'm here because I received a summons.
Hey, there he is, my main village man.
Then Kuzco led Pacha into another room where there was a model of Pacha's village. Pacha instantly recognized his village, but he was confused why Kuzco had a model of it.
You got a pretty sweet little setup there on top of that hill, don't you?
Yeah, my family has lived on that hilltop for the last six generations.
Uh-huh. So tell me, where do you find you get the most sun?
Oh, I'd say just on the other side of those trees. When the sun hits that ridge just right, these hills sing.
Well, that settles it.
Really?
Yep, problem solved. Thanks for coming.
That's it? That's all you wanted me for?
I just needed an insider's opinion before I okayed this spot for my pool.
Your pool?
Poor Pacha was shocked. He watched as Kuzco squished the model of Pacha's own house and planted a model of Kuzco's new summer palace on top of it.
Booyah! Welcome to Kuzcotopia, my ultimate summer getaway, complete with water slides.
What?
Isn't it great? It's my birthday gift to me. I'm so happy.
But, where will we live?
Don't know, don't care. How's that?
Meanwhile, deep down in the dungeons of the palace, Yzma was at work in her lab with Kronk. She was plotting how to get rid of Kuzco so that she could finally become the ruler she had always wanted to be.
Ah, how shall I do it? Oh, I know. I'll turn him into a flea, a harmless little flea. And then I'll put that flea in a box, and then I'll put that box inside of another box, and then I'll mail that box to myself. And when it arrives, I'll smash it with a hammer. It's brilliant, 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 I tell you. Genius, I say!
Yzma waved her arms wildly in the air, and she knocked over a beaker. Kronk watched as the potion in the beaker spilled onto a plant. The plant shriveled and died. Yzma reconsidered her plan.
Or, to save on postage, I'll just poison him with this.
Take it, Kronk. Feel the power.
Oh, I can feel it.
Our moment of triumph approaches! It's dinner time!
So Yzma decided to have a dinner party for Kuzco. Kronk was thrilled because he had secret ambitions to become a famous chef. He was particularly proud of his spinach puffs. Now, as I said, Kronk wasn't the brightest guy in the world. As a result, he managed to mix up the drinks when Kuzco arrived. In fact, he didn't know which of the three drinks contained the poison for Kuzco. So Kronk signaled Yzma not to drink.
Don't drink the water.
As Kuzco drank, the two watched. At first, nothing happened.
Hey, Kronk, can you top me off, pal? Be a friend?
Then, suddenly, Kuzco turned into a llama. Shocked, Yzma ordered Kronk to hit him on the head.
Hit him on the head!
and so Kronk knocked Kuzco out.
Take him out of town and finish the job now!
So, following Yzma's orders, he went ahead and put Kuzco the llama into a sack and headed out to the canal. But just as he was getting ready to throw the sack into the water, Kronk's shoulder angel and devil appeared.
You're not just gonna let him die like that, are you?
Then the shoulder devil arrived.
Don't listen to that guy. He's trying to lead you down the path of righteousness. I'm gonna lead you down the path that rocks.
As his shoulder angel and devil continued to argue, Kronk realized he really couldn't decide what to do.
Oh, boy.
Think. What to do? What do we do with the body?
So he flung the sack over his shoulder. And then, before he even had a chance to make up his mind, Kronk tripped over a cat. The sack flew out of Kronk's hands and into the air. Now, you're gonna love this. Remember the nice villager named Pacha, whose home was going to be destroyed by Kuzco? Well, Kuzco, the llama, who was still unconscious and tied up in a sack, just happened to land on the back of Pacha's cart. And so it happened that Pacha, unbeknownst to him, drove home with the emperor tied up in the back of his cart. Down the road, up in the hills, Pacha's family was eagerly anticipating his arrival. Pacha had two kids, a boy named Tipo and a girl named Chaka. They had just had their heights measured against a doorframe by their mother, Chicha. But Tipo wasn't quite satisfied.
Mom, I think I'm still growing. Measure me again.
All right, Tipo, stand still and let's see.
Mom, you and I both know that it's impossible for him to have grown in the last 5 minutes. Isn't it?
When Pacha arrived, his kids couldn't wait to tell him all the exciting things that happened that day.
Dad, I ate a bug today.
Oh, was Mom baking again? Don't tell her I said that.
I heard that. Okay, everybody, move aside. A lady with a baby coming through.
Dad, look at how big I am.
We were all measured today.
Oh.
I'm going through a growth spurt. I'm as big as you were when you were me.
Mm-hmm, you sure are.
That's not as impressive.
Okay, you two. Our deal was that you could stay awake until Daddy came home. Now say goodnight.
Dad, do we have to?
No, you two can stay up. We're just gonna be sitting here telling each other how much we love each other. Right, honey?
Good night.
The kids ran off to bed, and Chicha asked Pacha why the emperor had wanted to see him.
Oh, you know what? He couldn't see me.
Couldn't see you? Why not?
I don't know.
Well, that's just rude.
Well, he is the emperor. I'm sure he's busy.
No. Now, emperor or no emperor, it's called common courtesy.
Honey?
If that were me, I'd march right back there and demand to see him, and you know I would.
Pacha smiled, kissed his wife, and went off to unload his cart. Poor fella. He was such a nice guy. He just wanted to figure out what to do about his village. This was so unfair.
Hi, excuse me. 2 seconds here. I'm the one in the cart, remember?
Huh? Oh, yeah. I almost forgot about Kuzco, the emperor. The llama. The emperor / llama / spoiled guy. You see, this story...
This story's about me, not him.
Okay, right, fine, whatever. Just let me tell the story, okay? So, Pacha took the sack off his cart, and who should peek out at him but this strange llama thing?
Whoa. Where'd you come from, little guy?
No touchy.
Demon llama!
Demon llama? Where?
Okay, demon llama. Just take it easy. I mean you no harm.
What are you talking about? Oh, wait. I know you. You're that whiny peasant.
Emperor Kuzco?
Chia, who do you think you were talking to?
You don't look like the emperor.
What do you mean I don't look like the emperor?
Do this.
What is this, some kind of little game you country folk like to...
Yeah!
It can't be! My face!
My beautiful, beautiful face. I'm an ugly, stinky llama. Llama face.
Okay, so they figured out that Cusco was the emperor and that he was also a llama. But they were still having a few problems understanding the bigger picture.
What happened?
I'm trying to figure that out, okay?
I can't remember. I can't remember anything. Wait a minute. I remember you. I remember telling you that I was building my pool where your house was, and then you got mad at me. Oh! And you turned me into a llama.
What? No, I did not.
Yes, and then you kidnapped me.
Why would I kidnap a llama?
I have no idea. You're the criminal mastermind, not me.
What?
You're right. That's giving you way too much credit. Okay, I have to get back to the palace. Yzma's got that secret lab. I'll just snap my fingers and order her to change me back. Hey, you. No time to waste. Let's go.
Pacha stood his ground.
I can't let you go back unless you change your mind and build your summer home somewhere else.
I got a little secret for you. Come here. No, closer. I don't make deals with peasants!
Then I guess I can't take you back.
Fine. I don't need you. I can find my own way back.
And so the Emperor Llama headed into the jungle on his own. Okay, so think about this situation. We have a spoiled emperor who never did anything on his own, wandering through a wild jungle trying to fend for himself. Not to mention that he was walking on four llama legs instead of two human feet, and he had no idea where he was going. He did okay for a while. He even met a cute little squirrel named Bucky. Bucky was offering Cusco an acorn. You'd think even a spoiled emperor could be nice to a cute little squirrel offering him an acorn, right?
Hit the road, Bucky!
Now, let me give all you listeners a little tip here. Don't be mean to cute little squirrels. If you do, you could end up in bigger trouble, like in a pit full of hungry jaguars. So as Bucky looked on, Cusco galloped, walked, and tripped his way through the jungle with a pack of jaguars in hot pursuit. Not a good place to be. On the other hand, it wasn't as bad as when Cusco found himself backed up at the edge of a cliff, jaguars on one side, huge precipice to fall into on the other side. Not good. Now this is where you realize how good a guy Pacha really was. For suddenly, he appeared out of nowhere, swinging on a vine.
Don't worry, Your Highness, I gotcha. You're safe now.
Until the vine they were swinging from broke. And they fell into a raging river.
Maybe I'm just new to this whole rescuing thing, but this, to me, might be considered kind of a step backwards, wouldn't you say?
No. It's okay. This is all right. We can figure this out.
Then, something even worse happened.
Uh-oh.
Don't tell me. We're about to go over a huge waterfall.
Yep.
Sharp rocks at the bottom?
Most likely.
Bring it on. Booyah!
Well, they made it. Barely. But the worst was yet to come. The villager and the emperor slash llama now had to camp out together. But Pacha tried to take the opportunity to convince Cusco that he shouldn't destroy Pacha's village.
I just think, if you really thought about it, you'd decide to build your home on a different hilltop.
And why would I do that?
Because, deep down, I think you'll realize that you're forcing an entire village out of their homes just for you.
And that's bad.
Well, yeah. Nobody's that heartless.
Now take me back.
What? Wait. How can you be this way? All you care about is building your summer home and filling it with stuff for you.
Doi. Me. Everyone else in the kingdom gets it. You're the only one that doesn't seem to be with the program. Eh, Pacha?
You know what? Someday you're going to wind up all alone. And you'll have no one to blame but yourself.
Thanks for that. I'll log that away. Now, for the final time, I order you to take me back to the palace.
Looks to me like you're stuck out here. Because unless you change your mind, I'm not taking you back.
Meanwhile, Yzma was back at the palace pretending to mourn the loss of Emperor Kuzco. After the funeral, Kronk cooked a meal for Yzma.
Kronk, darling, I must admit you had me worried when you mixed up those poisons. But now that Kuzco is dead, all is forgiven.
Oh, yeah, he's dead all right. I mean, you can't get much deader than the dead he is right now, unless, of course, we killed him again.
Now, let me explain something about Kronk. Even though he may have been lacking in brain cells, there was something inside of him that told him it wasn't okay to lie.
Kuzco is dead, right? Tell me Kuzco's dead. I need to hear these words.
But you need to hear all those words exactly?
He's still alive!
Well, he's not as dead as we would have hoped.
Kronk!
Just thought I'd give you the heads up. In case Kuzco ever came back.
He can't come back.
Yeah, that would be kind of awkward, especially after that lovely eulogy.
You think? You and I are going out to find him. If he talks, we are through. Now let's move.
Okay, now Kuzco, the emperor slash llama, didn't have time to fool around anymore. But he didn't know this. In fact, he didn't even know that Yzma had tried to kill him in the first place. All he knew was that, well, that Pacha had laid his poncho over him in the night to keep him warm. This bothered Kuzco. He didn't know what to say.
Hey, thanks.
No, no problem.
I know you're thinking that saying thanks is like a given here, but let me tell you something. This was the first time in his life that Kuzco had ever said the word. Now, that's a big deal.
So I was thinking that when I got back to the city, we'd there's lots of hilltops, and maybe I might, you know, I might...
Are you saying you've changed your mind?
Oh, well, I...
Because you know that means you're doing something nice for someone else.
No, I know that. I know.
And you're all right with that?
Yes.
Pacha couldn't believe it. Kuzco could barely believe it. But the two shook hoof and hand on the deal. And then Pacha began to lead Kuzco back through the jungle toward his palace. But just when they got to a rickety bridge close to the palace, something terrible happened. One of the boards broke under Pacha's feet. He fell through the bridge and dangled from a rope above a group of alligators.
Whoa! Kuzco! Kuzco!
Yeah?
Quick, help me up.
No, I don't think I will.
You're gonna leave me here?
Well, I was gonna have you in prison for life, but I kinda like this better.
I thought you were a changed man.
Come on, I had to say something to get you to take me back to the city.
So all of it was a lie?
Well, yeah. No, wait. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it all was a lie. Toodles!
But as Kuzco was moving across the rest of the bridge, he suddenly slipped and fell too. Pacha quickly grabbed onto him.
Are you okay? You all right?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm all right.
Good! That's for going back on your promise.
Kuzco punched, well, kicked back.
Yeah, that's for kidnapping me and taking me to your village, which I'm still gonna destroy, by the way. No touchy.
Why did I risk my life for a selfish brat like you? I was always taught that there was some good in everyone, but, oh, you proved me wrong.
What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? We're gonna die? We're gonna die. That's it for me.
No, we're not. Calm down. I have an idea. Give me your arm.
Pacha and Kuzco worked together. Back to back, they pushed against each other so they could inch their way up the narrow gorge to the top.
You know, it's a good thing you're not a big fat guy, or this would be really difficult.
But just when Pacha was within reach of a branch, a bunch of scorpions fell down on him. Cusco tried to swing away from the scorpions, but his head became wedged in a hole that was filled with bats. Cusco pushed himself out of the bat cave, swung up into the air, and flung himself onto the ledge above him, dragging Pacha with him. They had reached the top.
Look at me and my bat self. I snatched you right out of the air. Oh, I'm a crumbly canyon wall, and I'm taking you with me. Well, not today, pal.
You just saved my life.
Huh? So?
I knew it.
Knew what?
That there is some good in you after all.
I know.
Admit it. Mm-hmm.
Wrong.
Yes, there is.
Nuh-uh.
I think there is.
Nuh-uh.
Hey, you could have let me fall.
Come on, what's the big deal? Nobody's that heartless. Don't read too much into it. It was a one-time thing.
Right, sure.
Well, while our poor little spoiled Emperor Llama was trying to get out of the fact that he had actually done something nice for someone, Yzma and Kronk were in another part of the jungle, talking to a squirrel named Bucky. Luckily, Kronk was able to speak squirrel.
I was a junior chipmunk. I had to be versed in all the woodland creatures.
Why me? Why me?
Hey, it doesn't always have to be about you. This poor little guy's had it rough. Seems a talking llama gave him a hard time the other day.
Oh, talking llama?
Do tell.
He doesn't really want to talk to you.
Well, then you ask him.
Hate being in the middle. Squeaky, squeaker, squeaking. Jaguars, no kidding, brutal.
Now ask him which way the talking llama went.
Squeakity squeak, squeaking.
Meanwhile, Cusco and Pacha were in Mudka's meat hut, eating a meal. Cusco dressed up as Pacha's bride, since llamas were not welcome in this particular restaurant. In a weird way, Pacha and Cusco were starting to, well, get along.
Okay, so I'll admit this was a good idea.
When will you learn that all my ideas are good ones?
Well, that's funny, because I thought that you going into the jungle by yourself, being chased by jaguars, lying to me to take you back to the palace, were all really bad ideas.
Oh, yeah, anything sounds bad when you say it with that attitude.
Unfortunately, their pleasant time together was about to come to an end. When Cusco went out to the kitchen to complain to the chef, Pacha overheard two strangers talking.
We've been walking around in circles for who knows how long. That is the last time we take directions from a squirrel. Ooh, I should have done away with Cusco myself when I had the chance.
Pacha's eyes grew wide in fear. He had to find Cusco fast and save him from this purple witch and that weird guy she was with. Pacha raced into the kitchen, grabbed Cusco, and finally managed to get him outside alone. There, he told him what he had seen. Cusco knew immediately who they were.
That's Yzma and Kronk. I'm saved.
Trust me, they're not here to save you.
They'll take me back to the palace. Thanks for your help. You've been great. I can take it from here.
No, no, you don't understand. They're trying to kill you.
Kill me? Their whole world revolves around me.
No, I can't let you.
What? What? Oh, I get it.
What?
You don't want to take me back to the palace. You want to keep me stranded out here forever.
No!
This has all been an act, and I almost fell for it.
Will you just listen to me?
No, you listen to me. All you care about is your stupid hilltop.
What?
You don't care about me now. Just get out of here. Go!
But...
Go on, get out of here!
Fine!
And with that, Cusco ran off by himself to find Yzma and Kronk, who by now had left Mudka's to resume their search for Cusco. But just as Cusco was coming up behind them, he heard the two having a conversation.
Oh, this entire mess is all your fault.
What'd I do?
If you hadn't mixed up those poisons, Cusco would be dead now. There'd be no more diversions until we track that llama down and kill him.
Cusco was devastated. As he ran to hide, all he could think of was one thing. He wanted to find Pacha, his only friend in the world. Of course, you had to feel a little bit sorry for the guy. I mean, I know he was spoiled and selfish and thought only of himself most of the time, and...
Just leave me alone.
Well, okay. I guess he'd learned his lesson. At least, a little bit. You see, now Cusco knew what it was like to have a friend, and he liked it. At least, he liked it a lot more than being a llama stuck in a field with a bunch of other llamas and nothing to eat but grass. Then, suddenly, something strange happened. He thought he heard a familiar voice.
So there we were, standing on the cliff, and the ground started to rumble. And just as it started to go, he grabbed me before I fell. Do you believe that?
It was Pacha. He was sitting in the field talking to a bunch of grazing llamas.
You know, call me crazy for following this guy all the way out here, but as much as he tries to deny it, I know there's some good in him. Besides, I couldn't just leave him out here all alone. He's a lousy llama. I mean, a really lousy llama.
Well, when Cusco finally followed the sounds of Pacha's voice, he was overjoyed to find the kindly villager sitting peacefully on a small patch of grass.
Hey, listen, Pacha. You know, what I said to you back at the diner, I didn't really...
So, you tired of being a llama?
Yes!
So Pacha and Cusco happily raced back through the jungle to Pacha's village to get some supplies for their trip to the palace. But as soon as they reached the hill, two villagers told them that a couple of strangers were at Pacha's house. It had to be Yzma and Kronk. Now, you may be wondering how those two figured out that they should look for Cusco there. Well, I'll tell you. The thick-headed Kronk had a thought. A memory, actually, and he remembered Pacha as the peasant who had driven away with the sack containing the emperor/llama. So he and Yzma decided to go to Pacha's house to try to find Cusco. Luckily, Pacha's wife, Chicha, was one smart gal. With a great deal of skepticism, she served Yzma tea.
So, remind me again how you're related to Pacha.
Why, I'm his third cousin's brother's wife's step-niece's great-aunt. Twice removed.
Uh-huh.
While the two women talked, Kronk was engaged in an enthusiastic game of jump rope with Tipo and Chaka.
99 monkeys jumping on the bed.
One fell off and bumped his head.
At least he was good with kids. Meanwhile, Pacha sneaked over to the kitchen window and explained to Chicha that he was trying to save the emperor, that Yzma was wicked and Kronk was, well, Kronk. So, to cover for Pacha, Chicha and the kids covered Yzma in honey and feathers and sent her rolling down the hill, where she became the piñata for a kid's party.
Ow!
Oh, there they go, Kronk! They're getting away!
Kronk tried to be polite to his hostess, Chicha.
Well, I had a great time. Let's not wait until the next family reunion to get together. I gotta run.
And run he did. With Yzma on his back, Kronk chased Pacha and Cusco all the way across the jungle. But luck was with Pacha and Cusco that day, and they reached the palace ahead of Yzma and Kronk. The two raced down to Yzma's secret lab and searched frantically for the potion that would make Cusco human again.
What does it look like?
I don't know. Just keep looking.
But as they were looking, Yzma and Kronk appeared.
Aha! Looking for this?
Okay, I admit it. Maybe I wasn't as nice as I should have been. But Yzma, do you really want to kill me?
Just think of it as you're being let go, that your life's going in a different direction. That your body's part of a permanent outplacement.
Hey, that's kind of like what he said to you when you got fired.
I know. It's called a cruel irony, like my dependence on you.
I can't believe this is happening!
Then I bet you weren't expecting this.
No!
Yzma tossed a knife to Kronk.
Finish them off.
Now, you know this could be the end of the story right here, but it's not. You see, first Kronk hesitated. Then Kronk's little shoulder angel and devil reappeared. The devil came first.
Hey, you're not backing down now, are you, big guy?
Where's the other guy? No!
Sorry, I'm late. Oh, what'd I miss?
Well, Yzma just tossed me this knife and asked me to, you know, take them out. And then this guy popped up, and then we waited for you, and quite honestly...
Kronk! Why did I think you could do this? This one simple thing. It's like I'm talking to a monkey.
Whoa now.
A really, really big, stupid monkey named Crunk.
Ouch.
And do you want to know something else? I've never liked your spinach puffs. Never.
That's it. She's going down.
Now, suddenly, Crunk, his devil, and his angel were all working together. It was a beautiful moment. They pulled their resources and they dropped a chandelier right on top of Yzma. Unfortunately, the skinny purple witch just fit through the center ring of the chandelier. She was completely unharmed.
Strange. That usually works.
But before he could do anything else, Kronk saw Yzma pull a lever that opened a trap door directly beneath him where he was standing.
Ah, could have seen that coming.
Whoa!
Now it was down to Yzma versus Pacha and Cusco. Yzma called the palace guards.
Kill them! They murdered the emperor!
No, wait, I'm the emperor! It's me, Cusco!
They're not listening to me!
We've got to change it back. Try this one.
Cusco did. He turned into a turtle. Then he tried another. He turned into a bird. Then a whale. And then a llama.
Wait.
Come on!
Soon, they plunged into a canal at the very top of the palace. They were swept along until the water emptied onto the front of the palace, where they clung helplessly, about several hundred feet above a very hard surface. And the worst part was that Yzma had managed to follow them all the way. Cusco and Pacha had to think fast. They pulled themselves up onto a ledge. Pacha looked at the remaining vials of potion.
Okay, only two left. It's gotta be one of these.
But just then, Yzma swung over and kicked them. The vials flew out of Pacha's hands. One broke right next to Yzma. It turned her into a kitty. Yzma the kitty leaped on top of Cusco's head and dug in with her claws. Pacha slipped, barely clinging to the side of the palace. He watched as Cusco finally got Yzma off his head. Then she slipped and fell, all the way down the front of the very tall palace. Don't worry, even evil kitties don't die in this story. Now the potion was within Cusco's reach, but so was Pacha. And Pacha was about to fall hundreds of feet. Pacha needed Cusco's help. But Cusco knew it would just take a second to grab the potion.
Cusco!
Be right there, give me a minute.
Cusco! Whoa! Cusco!
But it was too late. Not for Pacha, for Cusco. You see, he had actually turned into a pretty good guy. And he knew it was all because of Pacha. So he gave up on the potion and instead lended a helping hoof to Pacha. The vial fell.
The vial!
Okay, now this is where you're gonna have to hang in here with me. You see, when Yzma fell, she just happened to land on a trampoline that just happened to be in the process of being delivered to the palace at that particular moment in time. Yzma landed on the trampoline and actually bounced all the way back up to where Pacha and Cusco were. As the vial was on its way down, Yzma caught it on her way up.
I win.
But then she crashed against the palace wall. Yzma lost her grasp on the bottle and it rolled away from her, kind of close to where Pacha and Cusco were standing. Pacha looked at the bottle. Then he looked at Cusco.
The vial!
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Indeed, Cusco was.
Here, let me get this for you.
Well, see ya on the other side.
When he returned to being emperor, he realized he had a lot to make up for. After taking care of a few other things, he met with Pacha in the Cuscotopia model room.
So, you lied to me.
I did?
Yeah. You said when the sun hits this ridge just right, these hills sing. Well, pal, I was dragged all over those hills and I did not hear any singing. So, I'll be building my summer home on a more magical hill. Thank you.
Couldn't pull the wool over your eyes, huh?
No, I'm sharp. I'm on it. Looks like you and your family are stuck on the tuneless hilltop forever, pal.
You know, I'm pretty sure I heard some singing on the hill next to us, in case you're interested.
Cusco built a small hut on the hill next to Pacha's. And there, he found the love and warmth of a family he had never known. For Pacha welcomed him into his own family with open arms. As for Kronk, well, he found his new calling as a scout leader for the children of Pacha's village. Yzma the kitty even joined his troop. Not very happily, I might add. And being surrounded by the good villagers, Kronk never again had a problem choosing between right and wrong.